MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball brings us to the great state of Florida and Lone Depot Park in Miami. We've got an NL East contest tonight between the New York Mets and the Miami Marlins. Mike Trout, the league's top home run hitter, will look to widen his lead atop that board next. Nick Neidert, a right-handed Georgia native, gets the starting nod. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
This guy's kind of hard to figure out. You'd think most pitchers would love pitching in their home ballpark, but he struggled at home so far this season. There hasn't been a lot of home cooking for this guy, and that's something he needs to turn around and turn around in a big way.
And stepping in, Jonathan Villar.
Leading off,
and we are set for baseball here this evening.
First
offering on its way. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side.
First pitch, 7-10.
The 0-1 on its way.
One ball, one strike.
Guys, this Marlins ball club, as they begin play here tonight, they come off another loss last time out, and in fact, they've dropped three of their last four.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Ro, this has not been the kind of homestand that they would like to have so far. Through the first five games, they're 2-3. D-Ro, getting to 500 on this homestand is certainly one thing they'd like to do here today.
Yeah, they can salvage a little bit right now. They can walk out of here today with a smile on their face if they can get this back to 500 in these first six games.
And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Trout. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
The center fielder, number 9, Brandon Nimmo.
Next, it'll be Brandon Nimmo. First delivery to him. Hit out toward second. Fielded cleanly. And that's the second out. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. His home run total sits as the eighth best in the National League entering play.
You know, Matty, when I think of this guy, I think of damage near the league leaders in RBIs as well, D-Ro.
That's the stat that I think gets overlooked so much in today's game. I remember back to Chipper Jones. He used to say, how many biscuits can you put in a basket? Runs and ribbies. And he certainly has a knack for being able to drive in that big run.
The windup and the 0-1.
Yeah, this is straight survival mode. Down 0-2, the numbers are definitely not with the batter here.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a ball hard hit toward deep right. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. Mets go down 1-2-3. It's the Mets nothing. Marlins coming up. You're watching Major League Baseball on The Show. Marcus Stroman gets the ball in game 3 of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through his stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub 1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch this guy work in this one today.
Now to the plate, Starling Marte. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Check swing called strike, 0-1. Fellas, these Mets, as they enter play here tonight, they come in riding a 5-game winning streak, and they've really got things clicking.
Yeah, Matty, this team's coming together right now. They're playing dangerous baseball. You can tell the look in their eye. They feel good about where they're at. They've won a few games in a row, and they look to continue that trend today.
No ball.
Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Trying to get him to chase the cutter there. A ball and two strikes. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. It's a two balls and two strikes now. Half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning. So bases are empty with one gone, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. First pitch on its way. And a high strike there, 0-1.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
Now a swing and a ground ball for the second baseman, Cano. In time to first, and there are two away.
Batting first, the center fielder, Mike Trout.
Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout. Currently sits atop the home run leaderboard and seems to be heating up even more here in the dog days of August.
This guy has been on absolute fire. You get on a run like this, you want to show up to the yard at 1 o'clock in the afternoon for a 7 o'clock game. This guy is prepared, ready to go, and seeing the ball like it's a beach ball right now.
1-0 the count. Two out, nobody on. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. 2-0 count, the pitch. Too tight
ball
with that one. 3-0.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full. 3-2.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking deep.
Full count still. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Fly ball out toward left center field. Nimmo in pursuit. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Nothing in the Miami first. We played an inning in South Florida. No score on the show. Second inning set to go, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Randy Arozarena. First pitch coming, here it is. Fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. Hit back toward the mound, and that'll go as the Mets' first hit of the ball game.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up in the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Robinson Cano will grab a bat next. Now this is up and in, and I don't think he likes that location much. It's ball one. Arozarena gets his lead at first, nobody out. And he takes a called strike one. Time to check our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
You know, this is one of the guys behind the dish, Freddie Ferguson, Dan, that the rookies are going to have a tough time with. If you've played in the league for a little bit, you understand that he's got his own zone.
You touched on it, D-Roy. I think he rewards the veteran players, not only pitchers, but position players. He makes the younger players, he makes them earn their keep.
Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Aye. Got him. fooled on the pitch as he swings at it in the dirt for strike three. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Pretty standard pitch sequence right there. Just how you draw it up in a perfect world. Jump ahead 0-2, and then you toss a changeup in the dirt to get him to chase for a strikeout on three pitches. If only it were always that easy.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Nope. Ball one.
No score here as we play inning number two. That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. After it is Marte. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. At the plate now is James McCann. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. First offering. Down and in here. One ball, no strikes.
Ball three.
1-0 pitch is a curveball. That looked good from here, but it's 2-0.
When hitters are able to lay off curveballs and get themselves into good counts because of it, you're in pretty big trouble as a pitcher. A lot of guys rely on their opponents offering at that pitch, even when it's not in a good location to hit.
There's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
It'll be interesting if he comes into zone aggressively again here. With the base open, he doesn't have to.
Ready with the 3-1.
Full count.
And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Mets leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. So now to the plate, Jesus Aguilar. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Cut fastball inside. Ball one. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Left fielder is on the move. He's there and records the first down.
That is good. The right fielder, Nick Castellanos.
Nick Castellanos now comes in 0-for-9 in the series so far, so looking to turn things around in this one. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Aye.
Bottom of the second here with no score. Slider, and he can't pull the trigger. Two strikes. Stroman has a reputation as a strike thrower, although that doesn't often result in a ton of strikeouts. A typical start may find him with a low walk total and the ball in play a lot.
Matty, he's what they call today one of those pitch to contact kind of guys. He has good stuff, not great stuff. He relies a lot on his defense, and one of the keys, he's not afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. With that said, he needs some defense behind him because he's not going to get a whole lot of swings and misses.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Rounded down the third baseline. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Boy, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, and he was able to get that one to left field.
To the plate now, Jazz Chisholm. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll start play with that average down in the low 230s. 10 home runs and 28 RBIs. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Marlins leave one. We'll move to the third with no score. And here's Jose Peraza. He went deep in the contest last night.
The left field. Jose.
First pitch of the AB now.
1-0.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Chisholm backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out. So with one gone in the inning, we'll take a look at where these guys sit in the standings, and I think they can pretty much start to think about next year, because they are well back in the division race. So here now is the pitcher, Marcus Stroman. First delivery to him. Fastball that gets the inside corner, strike one. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Trout comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number two.
The first base.
Next for the Mets, Jonathan Villar. He flew out in his last AB. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss. 0-1.
Hey, make no mistake about it. This lineup's going to have to get going and get a little bit more aggressive. This guy's pounding the zone.
A ball and a strike to the Mets first baseman.
One and one.
After watching that one go by and a ball being called, you can rest assured he knows he's not getting away with another one of those. I guarantee you he's going to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. A line drive that's going to be caught out there at short. Pretty much right in the glove that time, and the inning is over.
Welcome back. As the Marlins look to get the offense going in the third, and this is a lineup that has had its struggles this season. At the start of the day, they have the worst team batting average in the league. And when I talked with one member of the coaching staff, he told me there's really no good excuse or explanation for it. Even though batting average isn't the end-all be-all of offensive stats, he said there's no denying they have to figure out how to be more competitive with their at-bats. Back to you, Matt.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. And now here is Jorge Alfaro. And you can see his home road splits there. He has not fared very well in front of the home crowd, oddly enough. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. Alfaro swings a bat and throws from the right side and stands at 6'3". This is his sixth season for him in the big leagues. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control. 0-2.
Great job by the pitcher right there, changing eye levels. We all know he's a sinker ball pitcher, but if he could throw some four seamers up in the zone like that, it could work for him.
Here comes the 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Stepping in now, Nick Neider. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. Now here's the pitch. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Here's Starling Marte. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. Now the 1-0. To 1-2 now. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
There's ball four.
Well, when you go with the slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
So two down and a runner at first, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. From the belt, the pitch.
No doubt, this is a steal situation right here. Two outs and the leadoff hitter on first. This is the time you roll the dice and hope he gets in the scoring position where he can get a hit to bring him home.
The 0-1 on its way. Pitch inside, the throw is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Marte stands at second with two gone. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Lifted the other way out to left center. Stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. One left for Miami. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. New inning set to get underway, and next it'll be the outfielder, Brandon Nimmo.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
And the pitch.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch.
I got to count 1-2. Two balls. two strikes.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. 2-2 one more time. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
I'll tell you right now, this guy has a shutout going, and it's been all business. He's not messing around trying to pick at corners. He's being aggressive in the zone, and he's attacking each and every one of these hitters up to this point.
And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. As he'll take a look at ball one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Now the 1-0. Count even now at 1-1. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Softly hit to short. Reined in. Throw on to first. Two gone. So two are gone in the Mets half of the fourth. And up next will be Randy Arozarena. First pitch on its way. As he will take a look at a fastball in there as that strike zone expands just a little. It's 0-1. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Here comes the 1-2.
I got to count 2-2.
No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Popped him up. And no one will track it down. Here's another 2-2. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Mets. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring forward the veteran outfielder, Mike Trout.
The center fielder, Mike.
Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Counts even to Trout, 1-1. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there, good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Two balls and a strike. Here it is. Good slider there. Gets a swing and miss.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And this is yanked hard down the left field line. And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances.
Well, that's demoralizing right there. Nice job by the offensive player getting the head out. That's got to upset you, thinking that ball might have went foul.
But you know what, you hear it all the time, that good game baseball is a game of inches. One inch one way or the other could have been the difference between a foul ball and a base hit right over the third base bag.
Standing in now, Jesus Aguilar. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one.
Man, he's looking sharp so far. 80% of his first pitches are for strikes. He might be able to go the distance if he keeps this up.
And they go away here. It's a called strike, nothing in two, using the slide step to try to control the running game.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
One ball and two strikes to count. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
What pitch recognition right there. 90% of the guys are going fishing after that nasty slider.
And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit. He'll hold at second, and there are two aboard now.
These guys are in perfect position to break through right here and to take the lead. There is, without question, nothing tougher than back-to-back singles. You don't know if they're going to bunt. You don't know. They can do so. They have so many options at their disposal right now.
Nick Castellanos at the plate now. And here's the ball out towards straightaway center field. Nimmo is there, and he has it for the first out. He'll make it over to third base safely, so that puts runners at the corners with only one gone.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
So one out here with runners at first and third. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Brian Anderson. From the stretch, here's the pitch. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Popped high in the air. Davis takes charge and he's got it. Two down. So now here is Jazz Chisholm comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Here's the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Peraza is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Marlins strand a pair through four. Still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with the Mets manager to discuss his thoughts on his club's offense so far. And he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
The second baseman. Robinson.
All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring up Robinson Cano. First delivery to him.
Ball one.
The 1-0 home. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Hard hit toward the hole. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
J.D. Davis the next to bat. And he'll take strike one on the inside corner. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Oh. And there's ball one.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
1-1. Skied into straightaway right. Castellanos will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. So stepping in is James McCann. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. And here's a foul tip into the catcher's glove. Moves it to 0-2 now. One and two.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Trying to send him packing for the second time. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
The batter, the left fielder.
Runner at first with two gone, and digging into bat next, it'll be Jose Peraza. From the stretch.
No, that's down.
Cano is off of first with two away. And he falls behind now, 2-0.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
To an 0 count and the pitch. That's high and away, not close. 3-0.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Here it is, the 3-0. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
Now into the box, Marcus Stroman flew out last time up. Hoping to keep it tied, here it comes. Lays off 1-0. Ball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now.
Can't fall behind against the pitcher. Need to minimize pitch count against the easy outs, and this is certainly one of them.
Two down, runners at first and second. Hit to short, scooped up on the first, and the Mets are going to come up empty here as that ends the inning. Two left for the Mets. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production. And flat out, he told me they just need to put better swings on the ball right now. He said they're searching for ways to drive the ball with some authority because it's just not happening for them today. They haven't gotten an extra base hit yet, so it's been a real struggle getting guys into scoring position. But the key, he said, is not to panic. Sometimes you just have to fight through the downturns and keep your focus and energy high.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. First pitch on the way. Jorge Alfaro is at the plate now as he looks at strike one.
When you're hitting at the bottom of the order, you better be keyholed in the middle of the plate. You cannot allow pitches like that to go by.
And here's a ball hit in the air, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. A swing and a ground ball to third. Davis has got it, and there's one down now. Next, it'll be Nick Neider looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
And that gets the black on the outside. A good slider that time. Count is 1-2 now.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Digging in next will be Starling Marte. It was a walk in his last trip. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. Sixth inning coming up. Still zip, zip. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat.
Jonathan Villar.
First pitch of the AB on its way, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. One and one to the Mets leadoff hitter. Now this pitch sails up and in, and that leaves him muttering to himself. It's ball two. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hopped up, and this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. And another foul ball.
You don't see too many guys at this level be late on off-speed pitches right there. That tells me he was totally sitting on something else or was going automatic tape.
He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out. Now at the plate here is Brandon Nimmo. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. First pitch on its way. Yanked hard but foul to the right. A great job of changing speed there. It's 0-2.
Wow, this guy has been on top of it today, pushing the throttle and pulling it when he needs to.
Swinging a little blooper to center. Trout coming on, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Roll, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. He's keeping that front shoulder tough, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
Francisco Lindor is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Popped him up. Alfaro over to his left. Two down.
Now back.
Here's Randy Arozarena. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in this at bat.
Oh, one count. Here's the pitch.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside. Nimmo leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. Mets strand one, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Trust me when I tell you, no exceptions to the rule. Bringing blessings when I'm moving. That'll bring up Luis Arraez.
Leading off for the Marlins, his second baseman, Luis.
First pitch on its way. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Nimmo, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Now back.
Digging in next, Mike Trout singled last time up.
Wow.
First offering. Popped up, VR into foul territory, and this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
And there's out number two. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Jesus Aguilar. A fly out and a single for him so far. First pitch on its way. There's the sinker to start him out, missing down and away for ball one.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game. As a pitcher right now, you just can't lay a cookie in there 1-0.
Here it comes. Grounded weakly toward third. Davis grabs it cleanly. And a bit of a high throw that time, but not much problem over there at first, as that will end the inning. Miami down in order. Still no score. Here's Robbie Cano now. And guys, seventh inning already. Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulted in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. One ball, no strikes to count. The 1-0. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And this is taken in for out number one.
Now
so next to hit is J.D. Davis. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And now the first pitch.
That's the ball.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Strike at the knees. Evens the count at 1-1. And he looks at one in there, 1-2. One out, nobody on. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Pitching 1-1 is changing location and upsetting the hitter's timing. You do that,
and everything's going to be fine. In that strikeout, he never threw the same pitch twice in a row, and he won the battle because of it.
At the plate now, James McCann. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because his first pitch strike ratio is still under 60%.
Ani takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only one strike away from putting another.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Mets go down 1-2-3. We are still scoreless. Now to the plate, here is Nicholas Castellanos. He'll be the man to lead things off here in the bottom of the seventh. First delivery to him. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there at strike one.
His slider's been impressive all night long. If he can continue spinning it like that, he's going to be just fine.
Out in front as he grounds this one to short. Fielded cleanly. And the inning begins with a quick out number one. Next to stand in is Brian Anderson. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
Anderson.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. And that misses inside 1-0. Bases are empty. One man out. That looked like the sinker there. Dipped a little below the knees. And he popped him up. And that's going to land foul. Three and one.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Hit on the ground out to short. On to first, and there are two down. Next to hit, Jazz Chisholm. And then it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. First offering on its way.
Ball one, no strike.
The 1-0.
Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
Slow grounder to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. And this is still a nothing-nothing ballgame. So here is Jose Peraza. It was a walk in his last trip.
The left fielder.
And now the first pitch. Here's a slider that's inside 1-0. And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets bullpen. Fastball catches the black there for a called strike. Time to be alert for signs of tiring here in the eighth. He's a pitch away from 100.
Man, I love this right now. He's given it everything he has, given this team depth, allowing the manager to pick some serious matchups when it comes to going to the bullpen day.
Boy, you nailed that, Hero. Now you can go to your go-to guys, the troubleshooters, the guy you want to bring into close games. Anytime a starter can get you through seven innings, the eighth inning, it's a bonus. A job well done so far.
Dominic Smith comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. The average coming in at 266, 7 homers and 29 driven in.
One and one.
Low, it's a ball and a strike.
Well, he's throwing a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
One and two to Dominic Smith.
One ball, two strikes.
John Curtis is forced onto the mound now following the injury.
Number 39, John Curtis.
The 1-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair. One out, nobody on. Fastball just inside.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
The 2-2.
We got a full count. 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Here comes the payoff pitch. Bounced softly in front of the plate. And there are two away now. Here's a look at the final line for the Marlins starting pitcher, and he was really in command on the mound throughout the evening.
Hey, only allowed 3 hits in this one, kept the hitters off balance, and was a lot of fun to watch.
So now to the plate, Jonathan Villar. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one.
That
1-0 pitch is right there, but ruled a ball. 2-0.
He may be down 2-0 after those first 2 pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They didn't miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. Two and one. Here it is.
Ball, that's out.
Brandon Nimmo would be next. High fly ball out to deep right field. Going back is the right fielder. And as Mets fans have heard before, that ball's out of here. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as they've taken a 1-run lead.
If you want to certainly drive home runs out of the ballpark, then you better get on the gas. And that's what he did right there. That fastball was not sneaking by him.
And here's the former first-round draft choice, Brandon Nimmo. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth. It's 1-0 Mets. Trevor May is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 65, Trevor May.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go. And up next will be the big catcher, Jorge Alfaro.
Jorge Alfaro.
First pitch coming, here it is. He'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Final line there for the Mets starting pitcher. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
Corey Dickerson will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Dickerson.
First pitch of the AB now as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. Six home runs and 47 RBIs. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Not close. It's 2-0.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Liner toward right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
This is the cat and mouse of baseball right here. Batter versus pitcher. You fight so hard as an offensive player to get count leverage. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. Check out the batting averages in those counts. And then check out the batting averages in even and behind counts with two strikes. 2-0, your eyes light up and the batter didn't miss it.
In now, Starling Marte, as he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Quick check on that tying run at first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. And there he goes toward second. Pitch inside, the throw. Not going to get him as he strikes second. The 1-1 home. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Birdie leads off second with one gone in the inning. Oh, and a look what I found out there on the mound. And they'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. Next up, Luis Arraez. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
And then Yank just fouled. The set and the 1-1. To 1-2 now. Davis is over to take a look at it. And this is going to be a foul ball. Here's the 1-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Pulled toward right center field. Rosarena is there to make the catch, and they'll get out of this with the lead intact. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. More to come from Lone Depot Park right after this. Roberto Osuna comes on to work now, and he's their usual closer, but this is obviously not a save opportunity.
Yeah, and this is all about just getting him some work, guys. He hasn't had a chance to come in and close a game out for several days now, so they're just hoping they can keep him sharp and give him the chance to pitch in a real game situation here.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Francisco Lindor is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2. That misses 1-2. And now a pitch on the way. Still 1-2. Now the pitch.
Two balls.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
The 2-2. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp, and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Into the box, Randy Arozarena. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Marte on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
The batter,
here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Robinson Cano.
Cano waits on the first pitch. No balls and one strike.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
Here's the 0-1. Slapped hard the opposite way. And that is in there for a two-out base knock.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of the baseball season. Bottom line is, this guy has bat-to-ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
To the plate now, J.D. Davis, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
Hey, this offense has this closer in trouble right here. They have to find a way to keep applying pressure. I don't know. Everybody top step in the dugout. Get on this guy and make him nervous.
Here comes the 1-2.
2-2 now.
One run game here in the top of the ninth. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Well, this has been a good at-bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Mets lead one. They lead it 1-0. Seth Lugo comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 67, Seth Lugo.
Into the box, Mike Trout has got a hit in three at-bats to this point.
Hey, not an easy thing to do to try to come back and tie a game or take the lead off of a guy like this, one of the game's elite closers.
As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Ball. A ball and a strike.
One ball, one strike.
Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. Got him swinging in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Trout is retired, and there's one away. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you see, he's up near the top, currently tied for second in that category in the National League. So the next to bat will be Jesus Aguilar. He grounded out last time up. Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Good opposite field power here, taken high and deep to right. Rosarena is back to the track as he takes it for out number two.
The right fielder.
Up next from Miami, Nicholas Castellanos. He bounced out last time up. First offering on its way. Breaking ball called just a bit low. Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth. Hit hard up the middle, and that'll get down for a two-out single. The throw into second, and he'll get in there safely.
Everyone knows there are no awards for successfully getting 26 outs. You need to get all 27 before you can start celebrating. That two-out double here tonight, putting the equalizer on at second base. A couple minutes ago, this thing looked like it might be over, but everything can change with one swing of the bat.
And now in the box, Brian Anderson. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
First pitch on its way.
1-0.
Ready with the 1-0. That one bends into the zone. A strike on the breaking ball.
Great pitch right there. That is a huge breaking ball. Not shocked he took it. Got to calibrate that one for a second.
Two balls and a strike to count. Two and one. Here it is. Taken, called, strike two. And now they're down to their final strike tonight. Miami down to their last strike. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over.
Wow, that game flew by, but that's what happens when you get a well-pitched one-run game. Both hurlers battled, and it's almost a shame somebody had to lose this one.
And that one run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. New York came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Marcus Stroman records the victory, his 13th of the year. Seth Lugo records the save, his 34th. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Born January 26, 36, but I never the brick. When I shoot, I never brick. When I shoot, it swish.